Hi everyone, this is the Billiards Doctor, and for today's video I want to teach you guys how to make extreme cut shots, very extreme cut shots. And what I do is I use a lot of outside English, and I allow the cue ball to spin the object ball in the pocket. So here's our first shot. This is near impossible. I will probably miss this, to be honest, but we'll see. Maybe I'll get lucky. You can see here that the angle to make this, that's very severe. That might almost be impossible, but we'll give it a try and see what happens. So we're gonna use a lot of outside English. I'm just gonna nip the very edge of the 10 ball. Hopefully it'll go in. There we go. Okay. So that was a very hard shot. I'll do another one for you guys, just so you can see another shot. But this shot, you have no cue ball control. You are putting all of your eggs into making that object ball. So here's another shot. Another shot. That's also pretty much impossible. This is harder. Maybe a little bit easier, but I'll go up to it. I'll put a little bit of outside English. And one thing to keep in mind is, that first shot, it may have looked like I didn't use outside, but I did. And the reason is because when you're hitting it into the rail so hard, the cue ball actually comes out really flat. So it came out flat. In this shot, you'll see when I use the outside English, it's gonna hit it, it's gonna fly all over the table. So you have to keep in mind when you're doing this shot, you really have no cue ball control. So you're kind of gambling. But if it's a must make it type of shot, then you gotta go for it. So here's 10 ball on the side. We'll load it up with top right. Right English. Ooh, it barely got the edge of that. So see how that? We do outside English, and the key here is you want to hit at a medium soft speed. Okay? Medium soft speed allows the cue ball to have more time in contact with the object ball. Okay? So it's going to barely hit the very edge of it, but if you hit it really fast, when it hit the edge, it's going to fly off. Okay, if you hit it slower, it's going to hit the edge. It's going to kind of have a little bit of contact time with it. And during that contact time, if the cue ball is spinning, right, if it's spinning, like let's say I put right English, it's going to actually spin the object ball in the pocket. Okay? So we're going to have it here, and we're going to hit this, and we're going to spin it into the pocket. Okay? So that's what we want. We want to hit it at a medium soft speed. We want to use a lot of outside English as much as we can. I often like to use top outside. You can also just use regular outside, that'll work too. And you want to spin the object ball out of the pocket. Now, keep in mind that this is for tough angle shots, but you're not trying to control the cue ball. Cue ball is going to go all over the place. That's when the object ball is off the rail, right? So if the object ball is here, I can do it. In my first example, the object ball was slightly off the rail, you can do it. If the object ball is on the rail, right? On the rail, like this. Let's see, can you see that in the video? Yes. Object ball's on the rail, and we have a tough cut shot. Now we do a different technique. And this technique is to use inside English. So we're gonna hit with inside English, because now, instead of trying to cut it in clean, so the first time we were trying to cut it in clean, right? Now the cue ball's on the rail. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use inside English, cue ball's gonna hit the rail, and it's gonna spin this way into the 10 ball. So we're gonna hit the rail first, so the cue ball's gonna hit the rail, and it's gonna spin in and make our 10 ball. Okay, I have a different video on this, but I want to bring this up just in case if you didn't see it, so you know that there are different types of spins you do for different shots. If it's on the rail, use inside English. So here's on the rail, right? Inside English every time. All right, just like that, okay? If it's off the rail, like this, now we use outside English, okay? Inside English, on the rail, hit rail first, cue ball spins in. If it's off the rail, want to hit outside English, have the cue ball hit it, spin, and push the object ball in the pocket. Okay? So those are two different ways to do extreme cut shots. Like I said, the first way is the way where it's not on the rail, and that's you're not going to have any cue ball control, so really keep that in mind. There have been some controversy about how people do those shots. I like to do outside English. I feel that is the way to do those cut shots every single time, like no question. Even if I have a medium cut shot, I'll do outside English to get rid of the throw. As I talked about in a different video, cue ball throw, that's phenomenon. It's going to be pushing the object ball, so it's going to be, if we use outside English, we're gonna actually compensate for the throw. So it's gonna work. So I highly recommend you watch the video on that. It's kind of an interesting phenomenon.